So this week, we have been reading Paul's third letter to the Thessalonians, a letter which is considered to be the oldest preserved Christian document that we have, with date from 51. This letter is a pro for a Christian tradition not only because of its antiquity, but also because through its reading, I believe, as I read the whole letter preparing for this meditation, that there is a lot that is very rich with pastoral concerns, pastoral advices of how can we do ministry with people. So I would encourage you, as we are starting a new day of new year of ministry, that we read, that you read in your own time and learn from Paul's letter to the Thessalonians. But I want to focus this morning, Paul, in the first letter today, he is expressing a concern, the concern of holiness. He wants to make sure that the faithful in Thessalonians are working, are being faithful and working their way to holiness. And such concern applies for today as well. Holiness, as we know, is our universal call to be holy as God is holy. And so in our personal life, we are invited to continually ask God for the desire to be holy. And in our ministry, we also need to ask God to give us the wisdom to guide the people under our care to walk in the way of holiness. So this morning I just want simply, to remind you what holiness is and how do we work. What do we need to do to become holy? So holiness, as we know, from our studies and from all that we do, is a gift. It's a gift that God has given us at our baptism. Holiness has to do with being adopted children of God. It has to do with that divine election. So, but holiness is also a task, a responsibility. We are